Hello and welcome to Flying Bobbins. My name is Liz and today I'm going to be showing you how to make the Tilly and the Buttons Jaimie pyjama bottoms. I'm going to be making these using a Flying Bobbins sewing kit that includes all of the fabric and notions that you need to complete the project. My pyjamas are going to also have an inseam pocket, so I'm going to show you how to do that, but if you want to, you can leave that step out. So let's open up our sewing kit and find out what's inside. Here's my Flying Bobbins pyjama party kit. Let's open it up and see what's inside. So you get your Tilly and the Buttons Jaimie pyjama pattern. And this you can choose to make with this pattern trousers or shorts. And these go from a size 0, which is a UK 4, perfect for teens and tweenagers, and then going all the way up to a 10, which is a UK size 24. I've also included a Flying Bobbins pocket and eye mask pattern as well, so that we can add the pocket into these trousers and make a coordinating eye mask. I've got my piece of fabric there ready to make my pyjamas with. And I've got a coordinating piece of cotton tape for a decorative tie at the front. I've got my pyjama elastic, which is perfect for these pyjamas, just the right size. That's 25 millimetres wide and you get 1.25 metres. Coordinating reel of moon thread. And then I've also included, not a cat, if you heard her meowing in the background, hello Puss Puss. I don't wish I could put a cat in the box, but you know what I'm saying. I've got a lovely piece of elastic here and so that you can make your coordinating eye mask with your leftover scraps. And, oh hello, there is a cat in the box. And then I've also included a safety pin to help you with threading the waistband on the trousers and the elastic through the eye mask. I've also got here the add-on coordinating drawstring bag as well. So you get more tape to make your drawstring pulls. You get a piece of fabric to make your coordinating bag. So those fabrics go together really, really well. And then you get some instructions to go with that as well. And there's going to be videos on all of these. So let's crack on and get making those gorgeous pyjama trousers. So as well as your Flying Bobbins kit, you are also going to need a few tools. Some thread snips, your faithful unpicker just in case, a chalk pen or fabric marker, scissors or rotary cutter, whichever you prefer to use, some dressmaking pins and a tape measure. Now the first thing that I'd suggest that you do is that you need to wash your fabric just to eliminate any shrinkage. So go and wash your fabric and hang it out ready to dry. And whilst that's washing, you can get your paper pattern and we're going to look at measuring and cutting out. So let's take a look at our Tilly and the Buttons Jaimie sewing pattern. When you open the envelope, you'll find inside that you have a couple of folded up pieces of paper with your pattern printed onto it in all of the different sizes and also a booklet with instructions. The first thing that we need to do is just to decide what size you're going to make. If you open it up to page 2, you'll find this Find Your Pattern Size page. Now, on your pyjama bottoms, you're going to go by your waist and your hip measurement. So get your tape measure and measure your waist around the smallest part to get your size. Your hips are the widest area, which is normally 20 centimetres below your waist position. And you can look at these two measurements. What I always like to do is take these measurements on myself and then write them down in the corner here. And I can then look along this chart and decide which size pattern I need to make. Now with pyjama bottoms, they're not particularly fitted. They're not a very tailored garment or anything like that. So you don't need to worry too much. I would also say that if you're in between sizes, then go up a size. So if your waist is hovering between these two here, say a size 8 and a size 10, then go for the size 10. Just because it's always easier to take in than it is to let out. You can always tighten up the elastic that we've given you around your waistband to make them fit a bit better. And with pyjamas, it's quite nice actually if they're a little bit looser anyway. So they'll be nice and comfortable when you're lounging around. Inside, you'll find two pieces of A0 or A1, I think it is anyway, very large paper with your pattern printed on it. Now, you will notice looking at this that it looks rather strange because you've got this leg shape here and then you've got these bits at the bottom. And that is just simply because you can't fit an entire trouser leg. There isn't a piece of paper big enough. So what we do is you're going to cut out these two squares here. And you're going to stick them to the bottom of the trouser legs to create your leg pattern. You'll see that you've got arrows here or triangles. This says stick to back leg part one. And then you've got stick to front leg part two, stick to back leg part two, and stick to front leg part one there. So you just match up the back to the back and the front to the front. So that will give you your full length trouser leg. Now, if you're making the shorts, you don't need to worry about that part of it. You can just cut along this line here. It says here, cut or trace off here for the shorts. So you're just going to do that. And if you are making the shorts, I'd suggest that you just keep all the other bits in your envelope because you could always then stick the pattern back together if you did want to make the trousers at a later date. Now, this is a multi-size pattern. And most sewing patterns are multi-size these days. And what that means is that all of the sizes have been printed next to each other. If I hold that up, hopefully you can see, you've got all those lines, sort of a dotted line and a dashed line. And each line has its own pattern. Now, each of these lines represents a size. And if you look at one of the corners here, you'll see these sizes written 0, 1, 2, and so on all the way up to 10. So you'll have measured yourself and decided which size you're going to make. And then what I like to do is grab a highlighter pen, because this helps me out. And I like to trace the line that I'm going to cut around with a highlighter so that when I'm cutting, it's really easy on my eyes to see where I need to go. Now, I'm going to make a size 4, sort of in the middle. And that's kind of a dash, dot, dot, dash, dot, dot line. I'm going to follow this line all the way around and cut out my front leg. And then I'm going to do the same again on my back leg. And I'm going to cut out, all the way around there on that number 4 line. So I'll end up with two pattern pieces, a front leg piece and a back leg piece. Now you'll notice that you've also got the drawstring. Leave that because we're not going to do that on this particular tutorial. I'm using waistband elastic and then I've just got a non-functional decorative tie that I'm going to put at the front. If you fancy doing the drawstring ones, then Tilly and the Buttons do their own video, which is fantastic. And I think that that also covers how to do the drawstring. So I'd suggest having a quick look at their amazing tutorial that they do for following that. I've got my back leg, my front leg, my eye mask and my pocket all cut out and ready to go. I've washed my fabric, so I'm now going to show you how to lay that all out and get everything cut out. So I've washed my fabric, dried it and pressed it. I've got my paper pattern cut out and it's onto the exciting bit, which is cutting out your fabric ready to make your pyjama bottoms. Just a note about the lovely booklet that you get. You've got some tips here on cutting fabric and then you've got some cutting layouts. And the cutting layout will depend on whether you're making the shorts or the trousers. It will also depend on the size that you're making and on the width of your fabric. You can buy fabric in two different widths, either 112 centimetres wide or 140 centimetres wide. And there are different layout plans for each width of fabric. It just depends which fabric you go for. My fabric here is extra wide and this is showing me how to cut out. So I'm going to follow this one here. So the first thing that I've done, just move that out of the way, is I have folded my fabric with the right sides together here. So the right sides of my fabric are touching and this is folded in half and the selvages are together. So here's the fold and here's the selvages. The selvages are just, it's just a fancy word for the edges of the fabric. And normally selvages are quite distinctive. They've kind of got a different texture and they've got printing on them sometimes as well. So you just want your selvages to be together and folded in half with right sides together. And the reason why we cut out like this is because we're always cutting everything out in pairs. So what you're going to do is you're going to lay out your pattern pieces and you're going to cut out a pair of back legs and a pair of front legs, because you've got left and right on the back and left and right on the front. So you'll end up with four pattern pieces to make your trousers. I'm going to use the little bits of leftover space at the top and bottom to cut out my pairs of pockets. You need two pairs, so one for your left hand and one for your right hand. And then the eye mask as well. Now on every single pattern piece, you will see this long line here, and this is called a grain line. And you need to make sure that this grain line is running parallel to the selvage. So it's in line with the weave of the fabric. If you were cutting out and you're doing it off skew like this, you'd have two problems. First of all, your trousers would twist. And secondly, your pattern, your printed pattern, wouldn't be in the right direction. It wouldn't look so good. So we always make sure that our grain line, no matter what we're making, if we're doing a dressmaking project, is always nice and parallel to our selvage or to our fold. So we know that the pattern piece is true. So what we do before I start pinning is I'm just going to measure the grain line. So I take one point up here and I measure from the grain line to the selvage. So I'm just going to come along there. That's 19 centimetres from the edge, and I'll just pop a pin in to anchor that. So when I come down to the other side of my trouser, the other end of my trouser leg, I want that to be 19 as well. You'll be surprised just how much it can be out by. Just doing it by eye compared with actually measuring, you will be surprised. So there we go, that's 19 there. So I'm okay at the top. Just check, because you've twisted it a bit, check that it's still fitting on the fabric nicely. I'll pop a pin in there now, and I'll pop a pin in there. And just double check, so that's 19. It doesn't have to be 19, it could be any number you like, depending on the size of your pattern piece, but it's just making sure it's the same number here and the same number here, just to make sure that that grain line is parallel there. So that's that piece just in place. And then I'm going to do the same with my front leg, making sure that it all fits. I like to squeeze things up very tightly. I'm very economical with my fabric. And then I'm going to do the same with my eye mask and with my pockets. And with my pockets, I need to cut out two pairs. So I'll pin and cut, and then I'll flip it over and I'll pin and cut. So I'll end up with four. So I'm going to go ahead and get pinning right now. Right, so I've pinned all of those pieces down and I'm ready to cut out. Just a couple of things I thought of whilst I was doing that. My print that I'm using goes in all different directions. So if I wanted to, I could have switched this pattern piece the other way, so that the waist was here and the hem was there. That is absolutely fine, doesn't matter which way around it goes. Also, I could have, if it fitted in better, I could have flipped this pattern onto the other side. So it really doesn't matter, you know, whatever makes the best use of your fabric. The other thing I thought of was that if you're working with a fabric or a print that does have a right side up, wrong side up pattern, let's say for example you had lots of little trees with all the leaves here and the trunks here, then you'd want all the trees to be the right way up. Just make sure, oh, hello puss cat, the cat's gone crazy today. Just make sure that your print is the right way up. Mine would be if I had a print that had a direction on it. This one doesn't have a direction on it. But just before you take scissors to a fabric, have a look. Is everything right? Is everything present and correct? Am I cutting two different sizes, or have I got myself in a muddle? Once you're happy that everything's as it ought to be, which it is, then you can start cutting out. I'm going to use my fabric scissors, which I only ever use for fabric, I hasten to add. And when I'm cutting out, I am just keeping my blade nice and flat on the table, and I'm cutting like this. And I'm trying to cut using the full length of the blades. I've had these scissors for how many years? A lot of years. More than 20, that's for sure. When you're cutting out, I always keep all of my scraps in a little bag or a little bundle, because you can use those for testing your stitches, and you can use them for making cute little extra projects with. So I like to keep all my scraps because they're really useful. Isn't that a lovely sound? That's my favourite sound in the world. Beautiful. Such a nice sound. Scissors cutting out fabric. You don't get that with rotary cutters. Move the eye mask out of the way for now. I'm going to go round and cut out around all of this, but before I do that, I'm just going to talk to you about notches. You'll notice these little lines here at intervals throughout the pattern. What you're going to do is when you come to one of these little lines, once you've cut everything out, just take your scissors and make a tiny little snip. It does not have to be too big. If you're nervous about making a cut into there, then get your fabric marker pen or your chalk and make a chalk mark instead. But all these notches do is they help you match up the different pattern pieces. They help you match everything together. So once you've cut out your pattern piece, you're then just going to snip in wherever you see a notch. I'm going to save my offcuts and cut out my front and back legs and my pockets and my eye mask, make a little pile with all of those pieces and keep all of my scraps. When I come to an awkward area like this, what I like to do is I just cut straight across and just carry on to the easier bit. And then what I'll do is once this trouser leg is cut out and I can move it round and get into there, I'll then cut this bit afterwards because it'll be easier to get to. At the moment it's a bit awkward, but once that trouser leg is cut out and I can get to it, I'll then cut out any awkward bits there. You'll notice as well that when I'm cutting, I'm right on the edge of this paper. So pretty much all modern sewing patterns include the seam allowance. So you don't need to cut a centimetre away from the edge. You are cutting right next to the edge of your paper. It's an absolutely gorgeous sunny day today, which is lovely, but the downside of that is I've got a big shadow across my table. So I hope you can see everything okay. So I've cut everything out. I've cut out my front, my back legs, my pockets, and my eye mask. Take off the pins, or first of all, make sure you've cut all the notches. Take off the pins, and then I'm going to fold up my paper pattern and pop that to one side, and I just pop that back in the envelope to make sure that it's ready for the next time I want to make a pair of these. Now, this is my back leg and this is my front leg. You can see there's a slight difference. The back is bigger than the front, but when you're making the pyjamas, it's not always that obvious. So my tip at this stage, so that you don't get confused, I take a chalk pen and somewhere I just pop a B for back on both of those. And I'm doing that on the wrong side. Remember that you've got the right side there. So it's just on the wrong side and it's in chalk, it'll wash off. And as I'm making my trousers, that will just remind me that this is my back, because you don't want to make your front on your back and your back on your front, because they are different sizes. If you think about it, your back is a bit bigger than your front, and when you sit down, the fabric needs to curve around. So if you just think that the back is always going to be bigger than the front. So I'm going to whip out these pins and do the same here with this one.
fold that out of the way. Oops, where have I left a pin? There it is. I'm not going to write an F for front, because if it's not the back, it's definitely front. another tip I'm going to share with you is once I've cut out, I've got my pile of pieces that I'm going to use there. I've just grabbed a bit of selvage. So I always keep a bit of selvage or a bit of fabric, and I just make a little bundle. So that is now my sewing bundle ready to make. And if I've got scraps of fabric, I don't know what I've done with them now, but I also make another little bundle with my scraps too, so that I've got a bundle of my cut-out pieces and a bundle of my scrap pieces next to my workstation, ready to go. So let's get our sewing machine set up, because we're ready to start sewing.